take a look at your site here. Here is the fixed up version that I made, and we got the image here at the top. This is fully visible now. Even though what I would say is I would get a different image. This one's kind of wonky. It's got kind of blurry areas on it and stuff, and it looks cartoonish almost. And also I would get it and I would crop it so that it comes up much closer to the top. You could even probably come right across about at this line here and cut off part of that roof, but just keep the top of this this architecture over here in the top of the sign. And then also, as I mentioned, make this sticky on top as you scroll. Now it goes away. I would leave that at the top the whole time. And then what we fixed up is we made the black area show over the top of the red area in both places at the bottom here. So let's take a look at what your original looked like. And here's your original. The image was not showing up at all, really. And then the bottoms here were getting cut off as the red was pushed up over the top of it with negative margins. So let me just show you a couple things before we even start working on your site itself. We're going to come into the site here. It's just a little test site I have, and we're going to click on our settings. And it's clear to me that you didn't realize that you could put in negative margins. So you can actually come in here and type in, let's say we want to go negative 40 pixels, and that will actually bring something up then 40 pixels. I noticed that you were typing it in as custom CSS. You don't need to. You can put in your top negative margin right here. Unfortunately, there's not a place on here for negative bottom margin, and with padding, you can't do negative at all. Padding always has to be a positive number. But if you got top margins where you want to slide one image up or one section up under or over another, you just put that in right here. The other thing is if you want to make that top section sticky, you just come in here and you say stick to top on scroll. So you stick to the top on the scroll. So that will take care of getting this part up here sticky. So now let's go into your site. So the first thing I want to do is pull up a copy of your image. So we're just going to right click on this. We're going to inspect that element, and then we're going to just come over here to where the link is to your image. Let's slide this over a little bit and let's go open URL, open it up in a new window. And then once we're in here, we can inspect this element again. And we can scroll all the way down to the bottom where we see that it is 1,048 pixels tall. It's always width and then height. So it's 1,048 pixels tall. So we can kill this. So what that tells us then is we want to go into this section and we want to set this section as a height of 1,048 pixels. Oops. Tab, there we go, 1,048 pixels. So now we have the full height of the image displayed on the screen. Well, after looking at it, I realized I really want to cut off about right here. So I think that came out to, what was it, about 700, I think. Oops, come on. Let's see here, about 700 pixels. Let's try that. Okay, and that's pretty close to what I had before. I think it was 690 something. So that way we just set the height of this entire section, and then this part here, because you had the negative top margin on this section, it will pull up over the top of the image. Now, a couple other things here. I see you had overflow visible here. You don't need that. I notice you have that in a lot of places, and I would guess you were just getting desperate when you couldn't figure out how to do this, and so you just started sticking that in everywhere, which is understandable. So now let's go down to the second section down here. Let's take a look at that. And one thing I noticed that you were doing a lot, besides putting in the overflow, is you were typing in margin top with a capital M. You never want to use capital letters in CSS. I'm actually surprised it worked. I didn't think it would work on a capital letter, but it did. So with that, but again, if you just go into the element, you can just tell the element to be a negative 50 pixels and you don't have to do anything inside the CSS at all. So we got that. So let's scroll down on the page and get to the real meat of the problem, which is right down here. So let's just right click and inspect on this element. And actually I want to come up to the row, So here's our row. And what we want to do with our row is to come in and we want to say z-index. And I'm just going to say 99. And then I'm going to say position relative. Okay, what that is telling the computers, because this red section down here, you have like a negative 40 or 50 pixels on it to pull it up. What this says is the z-index is a function of front to back. So think of like a word processor, Word or something like that. You can say send something to the back or bring it to the front. And that's exactly what this does, is this will now pull it to the front. The standard z-index on all this is z-index of 1. So if you made this 2 or 3 or whatever, guys always seem to do it in nines, 9 or 99 or 999. But so as long as you make that a bigger number than what the rest of the site would be, that will put that element in front of the other one that you pulled up behind it. So that's what we're doing here, is we pulled the red up behind the black. And then we said, okay, we want the black to be in front of it. So that's why we set the Z index to a higher number. And so then we'll just scroll down the page a little bit further, and we will do the exact same thing down here. We will right-click, inspect, find again the proper element that we're looking for is actually this row right here, because these are the columns, so we want the row itself. And again, we will type in Z index of 99 and position of relative. And that should do it. Again, I would go back through and clear out all the places. I saw at least a dozen places where you had your overflow visible put in there. You could take out, I think, every single one of those. And then, unless you needed them when you're going from the bottom over the top, which you shouldn't. And then, otherwise, just make a few of those fixes and start using the negative top margin that's built right into ClickFunnels. And I think that should do it for you. So if you've got any questions, just reach out to me.